Starting with the name of Allah Almighty, who is the master of the day of judgment, and a bundle of the Truth Islam and beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wa alihi sallam. Students, exercise 6B mathematics, class 7 of SAC students, and question number 2 is triangle ABC and PQR are similar? We have to explain that either they are similar or not. Students, both the triangles ABC and PQR are isosceles triangles, and you should keep in mind that the isosceles triangle have the congruent base angles, because if two lines are equal of a triangle, then their opposite angles will be congruent. So angle B and angle C will be equal, and in this triangle PQR, PR and PQ are congruent. So the base angles of this isosceles triangle are angle Q and angle R, and the value of angle R will become 50 degree because both angles are congruent. And students, first we will discuss both the triangle and find the values of the angles, and then we will compare the corresponding angles, and if corresponding angles will be congruent, then the triangles will be similar, and if the corresponding angles are not congruent, then the triangles will not be similar. So first we will find the values of the unknown angles. Students, first we will discuss triangle ABC, and we will apply the formula. Sum of angles in triangle is equal to 180 degrees, so angle A plus angle B plus angle C is equal to 180 degrees, and angle B and angle C, students, are congruent, so we will suppose that these two angles are X, and the congruency of these two angles, I have explained that if the two sides of a triangle are congruent, then their opposite angles will also be congruent. So angle A is 40 degrees plus angle B, we have supposed that is X, plus then angle C will also become X because both are congruent. So in place of angle B I will write X, as well as in place of angle C I will write X is equal to 180 degree, and this 40 is plus on left side, when we transfer it to other side it will become minus, and X plus X will become 2X is equal to 180 degree minus 40 degree. When we subtract 40 from 180, we will have 140 degree. 2 is multiplying with X, when we transfer it to other side it will divide, and the value of X will become 70 degree. So students, angle B and angle C both are equal to 70 degree. Now I will discuss triangle PQR, in which sum of angles in a triangle again is 180 degree. So angle P plus angle Q plus angle R is equal to 180 degree. In place of angle P, we will write as angle P, as it is, plus angle Q is 50 degree, as well as, students, angle R will be 50 degree because both angles are base angle of isosceles triangle and they have the same value. So in place of angle R, I will write 50 degree is equal to 180 degree. 50 degree plus 50 degree means 100 degree, so angle P plus 100 degree is equal to 180 degree, and 100 is plus on left side, when we transfer it to the other side it will become minus, so angle P is equal to 180 degree minus 100 degree, and the value of angle P will become 80 degree. Now students, angle A is 40 degree and angle P is 80 degree, so angle A and angle P both are not congruent. So these two triangles are not similar, but I will explain it like this. So students, we will write this in triangle ABC, correspondence with triangle PQR. Angle A must be equal to angle P if the triangles are similar. Now I will put the values of angle A and angle P. The value of angle A is 40 degree, and the value of angle P, we have found out that, was 100 degree. So angle A and angle P are not congruent. That's why these two triangles are not similar. The statement that is written is, so students, statement is written as corresponding angles are not equal, so triangle ABC is not similar. Students, this sign is the sign of similarity, and when we write line on it, it shows that it is not similar to triangle PQR, as their corresponding angles are not congruent. Student, second part of question number 2 is triangle DEF similar to triangle STU? Explain that either they are similar or not. Students, in my very first lecture of this unit, of this chapter, I have explained that two triangles or two figures will be similar if their corresponding angles are equal as well as their corresponding sides are proportional or the corresponding sides have the same ratio. Now we will find the ratio of the corresponding sides, and if the ratios of the corresponding sides is equal, then these triangles will be similar, otherwise not, and angles are not given. So we need not to compare the angles, we just find the ratios of the corresponding sides of these two triangles. So I will write. So students, I will write the corresponding sides in the form of ratio. So DE ratio ST, and you know that we can write ratio in the form of fraction. Suppose students, it is written 2 ratio 3, it can be converted as 2 over 3. So I have written the ratios of the corresponding sides as fraction, and if the ratios of the corresponding sides is equal, then the triangles will be similar, otherwise not. So I will write that DE over ST is equal to EF over TU is equal to DF over SU. Now we will put the values of all the sides in the given equality and then simplify them. If these numbers will be equal, then the triangles will be similar, otherwise not. Students, DE is 3.3 centimeters, so I will write 3.3 over ST, students, is 2.4, so I will write over 2.4 is equal to EF. Look at EF, the value of EF is 5.7, so I will write 5.7 over. Now look at the value of TU, and the value of TU is 3.8, so I will write it over 3.8 is equal to, look at DF, the value of DF is 5.4 over. The value of SU is 3.6, so it is written in this way. Now students, we will use calculator to simplify all the fractions, and if their answers are equal, then the triangles will be similar, otherwise not. Students, when you use calculator, apply 3.3 over 2.4 and we will get 1.375 is equal to 5.7 over 3.8 and we will get 1.5. And when we divide 5.4 with 3.6 and we will get 1.5. So students, two ratios are equal but third is not. Means these two triangles are not equal, so statement is written. So students, the statement is written as ratio of the corresponding sides is not equal, so triangles are not similar. We will find the value of C by using the formula. And the formula is sum of interior angles of any polygon is equal to n minus 2 multiplied by 2 right angles. So students, the formula for finding out the interior angle is sum of interior angles of any polygon is equal to n minus 2 multiplied by 180 degree. So students, you must remember this formula all the time, that sum of the interior angles of any polygon, either it is quadrilateral, pentagon, hexagon, octagon, decagon, how many sides a polygon has, we have to write the number of sides, then subtract 2 from the number of sides and multiply that number with 180, and that will be the sum of interior angles of any polygon. So here are 4 sides, so number of n means 4, so sum of interior angles will become 95 degree plus 108 degree plus angle C plus 105 degree is equal to, in place of n we will write 4 minus 2 multiplied by 180 degree, and it will become students 2 multiplied by 180 degree, and that is 360 degree. Now students, we will sum up all the 3 angles on left side and then transfer it to other side, and it will become minus, and we will have the value of angle C. Students, 95 plus 105 mean 200, 200 plus 108 mean 308. plus angle C 308 is plus on left side. When we transfer it to other side, it will become minus. And when we subtract 308 from 360, we will have 52 degree. And that is the value of angle C. So angle C is 52 degree. Students, we have to find the value of angle R and angle P. So angle R will be equal to angle R is written at third place. So at third place it is written C. So angle R will be equal to angle C, and angle R mean Y, and the value of angle C is 52 degree. So the value of Y is 52 degree. And student, X is written at point P, and P is the at the first place on the right side. So at the first place there is A. So angle P will be equal to angle A, and the value of angle P is X, and here the value of angle A is 95 degree. So the value of X is 95 degree. Now we have to find the value of Z, that is unknown, and two sides are given in this quadrilateral and one side is given on this quadrilateral, and we will take the ratio of both the sides as equal and then find the value of unknown. So students, BC over QR will be equal to AB over PQ, and I have written these numbers in this way. Now we will put the values of BC, QR, AB and PQ. The value of BC is 12 and the value of QR is 7.2. That will be equal to the value of AB is 8 and the value of PQ is Z that we have to find. Now students, we will do BCN. BCN mean by cross multiplication. Z will multiply with 12 is equal to 8 multiplied by 7.2. Now students, this 12 is multiplying on left side. When we transfer it to other side, it will divide and find the product of 8 multiplied by 7.2. 8 2s are 16. 1 carry. 8 7s are 56. Or 1 this carry mean 57 over 12. Now use your calculator to find the value of Z, and that is, and the value of Z will become 4.8 centimeter. So students, it's enough for today. May Allah Almighty bless you all the time.